let us start with the basic concept. A pointer is a variable that represents the location of a data item. So how do we declare a variable like this? First, we will cover all the basic concepts and then we will take some competitive examples so that you can understand those concepts very clearly. So variables to store value, you declare variable like this, the variable which can store values. But if you want to store address of any other variable, you need to declare a variable which is of a special type. So variables to store address of another variable, you declare variable like this. There are two basic operators in pointers which are used. One is ampersand and other is asterisk or pointer operator. This is also called indirection operator. So this ampersand operator is used to access the address of a variable, and you use this operator like this. Just place ampersand before the variable name. X, Y, Z is a variable, and ampersand is the operator which you place just before that variable. Let us consider that 1380 is the physical address where memory space for X, Y, Z has been allocated. Now, if you want to access the value of the variable if you want to access the value which is stored in a variable which is pointed by a pointer variable, you use this indirection operator. So suppose there is a variable of integer type which is XYZ, and if you store address of XYZ in any other variable P, then if you want to access the value of XYZ through P, you have to use this indirection operator which is called pointer operator. So it is these operators like this. Variables to store value like this, variables to store address of any other variable, int star p or asterisk p. This is a small code, int xyz, int star p. So we have declared xyz as an integer variable, and p is a pointer variable which is also of integer type. Remember the variable, both variables should be same. If xyz is an integer variable, then you have to declare the variable, pointer variable, that variable should also be of integer type. So what happens in the memory when you declare int xyz in memory? A space is allocated for xyz, and here you have declared a pointer variable p. Memory space has been declared for p as well. This is the address of physical location or physical address of p. This is the physical address of xyz. You have stored 50 into xyz, so this 50 has been stored in xyz, and by this statement you are storing address of xyz into p. So what you are doing, you are just storing the address of XYZ. 1380 is the address of XYZ. You are storing this address into P. So this is like this. Okay, so we can have a program, example of the program, where you have stored 5 in a variable A, and this is a pointer variable. You have stored address of A into PTR or pointer variable, and you want to print the value of PTR. You want to print the value stored in the variable whose address is contained in PTR. So you have to just understand the concept that why we are placing this star, because we want the value of the variable whose address is in PTR. So if we run this program, so here you can see that the value 5 is coming. Is it visible to all?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So you can see here that we have stored 5 into A, and PTR is a pointer variable, and here we have stored the address of A into PTR, and we want to print the value of A through PTR. So star PTR will print the value of the variable whose address is stored in PTR. So PTR is storing address of A, and A, the content of A is 5. So that's why you see here 5. But suppose if you just print PTR, so what will happen? Let us see. So here 5 is the value. Leave this 5 here. So 750, 759, 492. Can you tell me what, whose address is this? This is the address of A actually, which is stored in PTR. So what this address is, let me just write here \n so that we can see it in the different lines. And now suppose I want to print again, printf %d and address of A. Okay, and suppose again we want to print address of PTR. Okay, so these are all different things. Here you are printing what you are printing the value of the variable whose address is in PTR, that is 5. It will print 5. And what this second print statement will do, this will print the address contained in the PTR. Address contained in the PTR means the address of A, which is the content of PTR. And obviously this will fetch the address of A, and this will print the address of PTR. So there are two things. One thing is the content of PTR, which is printed by the line number 10. And other thing, the address of PTR, which is printed by statement number 12. So let us just run this statement and see what happens. But you can see that star PTR is printing 5. And this PTR is printing the address of, this is the address of A. 20258798, this is the address of A. And ampersand, and this you can verify by the 11th statement, that this is the same address. This is the address of A, which is stored in PTR. And this is the address of A, which is you are directly printing by using ampersand operator. And ampersand PTR is what? Ampersand PTR is the physical location where PTR has been allocated. Okay, so this is how you can see. Okay, here you can see that how we can just find out the output of a given problem. Int A equal to 5, I have declared a variable A and stored 5 in that. So I have just drawn this block. This is the memory location. A equal to 5, A has been allocated here, and 5 has been stored in A, and this is the address which is allocated to A. And here we have declared a pointer variable PTR like this. So this is the pointer variable PTR. By this statement, if we consider this statement, so this statement is doing what? This statement is storing the address of A into PTR. So what is the address of A? Address of A is this. You can see that this is stored in PTR. Next line is, here you are printing a star PTR. A star PTR will print the value of the variable whose address is contained in PTR. Which address PTR is containing? This address is in PTR. And the variable whose address is this is A. And it will print the value of that variable. So that will print 5. It should be very much clear that by writing star PTR, we are just printing the value of the variable whose address is contained in PTR. And this PTR will just print the address inside the PTR. Listen very carefully. PTR will print the address inside the PTR or content of the PTR. So this is the content of PTR. So this statement will print the content of PTR, which is also the address of A. And ampersand PTR will print the address of PTR. Understand the difference between these two addresses. This is the address of PTR, and this is the content of PTR, which is address of A. Now ampersand A is this. It is the address of A, obviously. So this is this address 452. This is the address, and this is the value of 5. Now what will this statement do? Star PTR equal to star PTR plus 1. Just understand this. Star PTR is what? Star PTR is the value of the variable which is pointed by PTR, that is 5, plus 1 is 6. So now the content of the variable whose address is in PTR will become 6. So after execution of this statement, the content of A will become 6. So it will directly print the value 6. And again, when we write star PTR, so it will print the value of the variable whose address is contained in PTR. So it will again print 6. Now A, B, C, these are the three variables. Now this is a pointer variable, and I have written just this statement: 4 into C plus 5, P equal to ampersand C, B equal to 4 into P star P plus 5. Now PTR A and B. So we want to print this value A and B. Now in the next slide, we will see what is happening. So we have declared a variable. If you want to solve this type of problem, this is the easiest way to solve the problems. You just draw the memory locations and just relate, execute, or dry run the statement one by one. So first statement is this. You have declared three variables A, B, C. So we have declared three variables A, B, and C. And in C, we have stored 5. Star P is the pointer variable. And in this pointer variable, we are storing the address of C like this. So P is equal to ampersand C. So we are storing the address of C into A. So this address is being stored here in this location. So now the value of A will obviously, this value will be what? C plus 5, the value of C is 5, so 10 into 4 is 40. So the value of A will become 40. Now here what is happening? 4 into star P. So what is star P? Star P is the value of the variable whose address is in P. So the variable whose address is in P is this 1, 2, 3, 4, and this variable is here 1, 2, 3, 4. The content of this variable is 5. So the value of star P is 5. So it will print 5 plus 5, 10 into 4 is 40. So the value of both the variables will be 40. What we can do with the pointers, how we can write the expressions of the pointer. Like other variables, pointer variables can be used in expressions. Okay. If P1 and P2 are two pointers, the following statements are valid. Remember, these statements are valid statements. What we are doing here, sum equal to star P1 plus star P2. This is the value which is pointed by P1 plus value which is pointed by P2. It means star P1 is a value, star P2 is also a value, and you can always add two values. There is no problem. You can always find the product of the two values. There is no problem. And this is also a product operation. You can add an integer in the value. There is no problem. So these all expressions are operations are with the values, not with the pointers. So all these are values, and we can perform all the arithmetic operations with the values. That's why these all operations are valid. Allowed in C, add an integer to a pointer. Yes, you can add an integer to a pointer variable. Subtract an integer from a pointer variable. Subtract one pointer from another. This operation is valid. If you subtract one address from another address, this operation is valid. This will give you the number of blocks between the two addresses. But remember that you cannot add two pointer variables. You can add two values pointed by pointer variables, but you cannot add two pointer variables. You cannot multiply two pointer variables. You cannot do P1 into P2, okay? But you can subtract two pointer variables. It will give you the number of elements between those addresses. This is a small program. A equal to 2, B, C, these are the integer variables, normal integer variables, and these are the pointer variables. So you have stored addresses of A, B, C into PTR1, PTR2, and PTR3 respectively. And here you are printing these values. Obviously, PTR1 will print address of the address of A. PTR1 will print address of A, which is content of PTR1. PTR2 will print address of B, which is content of PTR2, which is the address of B. And PTR3 will print the address of C, which is content of C, which is content of PTR3. What will this statement do? PTR1 plus 1. As you can see that PTR1 is a pointer variable, and it is containing this address. This address is what? 22956, and when we are performing PTR 1 plus 1, it will add one block in this address. So 2956 is the address in PTR 1, and when we add 1, it will become what? It will become 22960. Why it is so? Why it is increasing by 4? Because here the block size is 4, and the value of A is what? The value of A is 2 here. So it will increase. It will add 8 bytes because it will become 2964. Is it clear to everyone? The initial address of PTR1 is 2956. And when we are adding 2 to it, because the value of A is 2, then it will increase 2 integer blocks, that is 8 to this address, and it will become 2964. It should be very much clear to you. And when we are finding the difference between PTR3 and PTR1, so the difference between PTR3 and PTR1 is what? Here you can see that PTR3 is this value, PTR1 is this value. So it will give you the number of blocks between these two addresses. So as you can see that there are two blocks. There are 8 bytes between PTR1 and PTR3. So these 8 bytes will make 2 blocks of integer. That's why you can see 2 here. So I have already told you that this operation is possible. You can do this. You can find the difference of two pointer variables. But if you change this minus operator by, replace this minus operator by plus or multiply, it will give you error. You will, subtraction is possible, but addition or multiplication or division, any other operation is not possible. Yes, you can see here that which operations are not allowed, you cannot add two pointers, p1 equal to p1 plus p2, you cannot do. This is wrong. You cannot do it. This operation is not possible. You can also not divide a pointer variable by 5. But remember, if I place star here before p2 and star here before p1 also, then this statement will become valid. We would be dividing a value by 5. Okay. So if I place a star, so that will become value, and that value can be divided by 5. But here we are dividing a address by 5. It is not possible. Here you can see that minus operation is possible. Obviously, I have told you. But here in this expression, multiplication or product is also involved. That's why this statement is also invalid. Now consider this very simple program. Here you can see that there are two functions in this program, main function and swap function. We want to swap two numbers using a function. Okay, so what we are doing? We have declared two variables, simple program. We have declared two variables, a equal to 5, b equal to 20. And we expect that when we pass these two variables to the function, this function will swap these two numbers for us. Okay, so we expect that when we will execute this print statement, the values must be swapped, means the value of a will be 20 and value of b will be 5. But what happens? Let's see. This is the code. So this is function one or main function. This is swap function. Okay, so what is happening here? So in the main function, you can see that there are two variables. Simple, these are two variables. One variable is a and b. One variable is a, another is b. And we have stored 5 and 20 here. And these are the addresses. Now we are calling this function swap. And what is happening here in this function, in the second function, we have two variables, x and y. And we have another variable t also. So now when we call this function, what is happening? We are passing the values of a and b to the function. So the value of a is copied to x and value of b is copied to y. Okay, now this function will execute. Obviously, you know that how the numbers are swapped. So what will happen? These two values will be swapped. 20 will come here and 5 will come here. And when you come back, when after execution of this function, when control comes back to the main function, what will happen? Okay, so these values have not changed. You will get 5 and 20 in A and B respectively. Means what you can say that values have not swapped. See that here the values are not swapped and the values of A and B are 5 and 20 as before. Okay, so values have not swapped. Now let us see another version of the same program. Okay, so in this program we are using the pointers. So what we are doing here, we have a and b, two variables, a is equal to 5, b is equal to 20. These are the two variables having these values. Now we are passing, in place of passing values, we are passing addresses. Okay, so these are the values, a equal to 5, b equal to 20. So we are not passing 5 and 20, we are passing the address of a and the address of b. And since we are passing these addresses, we need pointer variables. Okay, so the address of A will be stored in X and address of B will be stored in Y. So let us see. So this is what happening here. This is these are the memory areas of the two functions, A and B. And this is the pointer variable X, pointer variable Y. So when we are calling this function, we are sending the arguments. So the address of A, that is 324561, this will be stored in the content of X. It will become the content of X, which is a pointer variable. Similarly, the address of B will be stored in the content of Y, which is also a pointer variable. Now what is happening when this will execute, when this you are calling this function and control is coming to this function, swap. Now this will swap. Now what is happening here? Listen carefully. Star X is actually a value. I already told you that star X is a value. So this value is what? This value is actually, so what does it mean? It means go to the variable which is pointed by X1. So go to the variable, so X is pointed by, X is pointing A, okay? So this A is pointed by X, or you can say that X is pointing A, okay? So the value of star X is 5. Similarly, you will say that value of star Y is 20. So what is happening here? Star X means 5 is being stored here. star y is stored in star x. So this value will directly stored in A. Okay. So this value will be swapped here. Sorry. This value will be stored here. Okay. Or you can see like this. It will be here in 20. And what this statement will do? This statement, you can see that the value 5 were there in T. So this value will be stored in B. So now you can see that the values are swapped, because using the pointers you are directly accessing the locations by the physical address. So you can apparently call any physical location in the memory as long as you are having the address of that memory location. So this is the one of the advantages of pointers. So you can see here that outputs are swapped. The value of A has become 20 and value of B is 5 here. Now let us understand some concepts of array, and then we will be having some competitive problems. So here you can see that this is we have declared an array, and these are the values stored in that array. Okay, suppose that the base address of X is 2500. What is base address? Base address is the address of the first element in array. When you declare an array, you can treat the name of variable as a pointer variable, and that pointer variable will store the address, the base address of the array. Okay, so if you have declared X of 5, it means the X can be treated as a pointer variable, and this X is pointing to the first location of array. So this will become 2500. Okay. So name of the array can be treated as a pointer variable. So now X and ampersand X0 will be same. I have already told you that the content of X will be 2500, and if you place ampersand before X0, that will also be 2500. So both will have same value. So both are actually same addresses. Now P equal to X and P equal to ampersand X are equivalent. Here you can see. So X is stored in P. It means first location of the array is stored in P. Okay. So P equal to ampersand X0. P is a pointer variable which is equivalent to X. So P equal to ampersand X of 0 equal to 2500. Okay. And X of 1 will be the second location. And what is the second location? 2504. So how will you access this, the address of the first location? By placing ampersand. So ampersand X1 is equal to 2504. And this is the same location. If you add 1 to the pointer variable, it will add 1 integer block. So obviously it will be the second location, means the location of the index 1. So that will be 2504. Okay, so you can say these are the same thing. P plus 1 is equal to ampersand X of 1. Okay, or you can also say that P plus 1 star, it is equivalent to X of I. Now let us have, this is a simple program function to find address using the pointer. We are passing array in this example. So we have declared this array X of 100, K and N. This is integer array. This is K, an integer variable, N, another integer variable. And we have scanned this N, and we have scanned the entire array. Okay, so should be no problem with this up to this point. Now we want to find average of all these numbers which are stored in this array by this function, which is the name of that function is AVG, and we are passing X. And I already told you that the name of array is a pointer variable. So X is actually a pointer variable because X is the name of array. So we are passing array by just writing X. It means we are passing the pointer. Okay, the count. Now we are just calling here, and here what we are doing, we are just taking this value array and size of the array. Okay, now we are receiving here int array and size. Star P is a pointer variable, P equal to array, because array is a pointer and P is a pointer. Okay, so P equal to array because we have received array from here, this point. Okay, so now we are adding this. So this is how we can pass the entire array. Suppose AR is a pointer variable. AR0 is the same as star AR. Can you relate this? Because I already told you that AR plus I star AR plus I okay, star AR plus I is equal to AR of I. Can you relate this? Similarly, AR2 is the same as star AR plus 2. Okay, so star AR, so if the value of I is 2, so it will become AR plus 2, means content of AR2. Okay, so this is AR2. So we can use pointer arithmetic to access arrays more conveniently. Okay, this is a function foo int, pointer type int. This is the main function. The value of I is equal to 10, foo ampersand I plus plus, and we are passing this value. We are passing what? We are passing ampersand I plus plus into p, and we are just printing p. So what is happening here? It would be a compile time error because ampersand I is an address. Okay, agreed. Ampersand I is an address, and we are trying to change this address. And I have already told you that you cannot add or subtract any integer in a pointer variable. I already told you. So this operation is not possible. You cannot add anything like this. Okay. I just want to make one thing clear, that if you do this, if you write p equal to ampersand I plus 2. So remember, this operation is valid because you are not altering address of I. What you are doing, you are adding 2 in the address, in this particular address, and storing this address into p. But here in this operation, you are changing this value. Here what we are doing, we are passing this address to p. We are just printing the content of p. Answer will be 10. Consider this program, which is similar to the previous program, but of writing plus plus, we are writing plus 1. Okay, so here, what is the difference of in this program from before? So in that program, we were trying to change the address. Okay, you are not changing this value I, you are just adding 1 and passing the sum to the function. So it will get this value and it will print something. Let us see what is happening here. You can see that it is printing 0 because it is denoting the next integer location. Okay, so in the current, in that particular location, current location 10 is stored, and in the next location that is undefined, you can see it is printing 0. It will obviously depend on the compiler. Maybe it may happen that if you run this program, you will see some garbage value, but in this particular compiler you will see 0. Now consider this program. What is happening here? The value of I is 97. Ampersand p is equal to ampersand I. In this function, we are passing ampersand I, the address of I, and we are printing the content of the variable which is pointed by p. Content of the variable which is pointed by p. Okay, so what is happening here? We are passing this value to p. The value of j is equal to 2. P equal to ampersand j, means j is, address of j is being stored in p. Let us see how it is happening. Okay, so here we have these variables, one variable I, one variable pointer variable p. So in I we have stored 97, in p we have stored the address of I, that is 236430. By this particular statement, what we are doing, this statement, what we are doing, we are just storing this address to p. Okay, and what is happening here, we have two variables here, j and p. Okay, in j we have stored 2, and in p we have stored the address of j. Okay, so this is the address of j. Okay, so now what is happening? You are passing this 97 and I, you are passing address of I. So what is address of I? Address of I is 236032. Okay, so this is what is stored in p. This is stored in p. Now the value of j is 2. The value of j is 2. Okay, so whatever address you have here of j, that will be stored in p. So it will print the content which is pointed by p. The j is the variable which is pointed by p. That's why it will print 2. And when after execution of this, control comes back here in this function, then the value which is stored in p is this, and this address is of I. So it will print the content of that variable, that is 97. Now this is another very small program. Character s equal to hello. So this is a string variable where you have stored hello, and this is another pointer variable which is storing the address of the first location of this array. Okay, so hello is an string, and the base address of that string is being stored in P, like this. Okay, now what is meant by this? One of P, S of I, S of one. What is this? Let us try to execute this program. Okay, so the output is E and E. Suppose you write P 1. Okay, so I already told you that this statement is equivalent to star P plus 1, and this you can write star 1 plus P, and this you can also write as 1 of P. Okay, so these two statements are equivalent, P of 1 or 1 of P. These are equivalent statements. Okay, so this will print the first location, that is P of 1. So this E is in P of 1, so it is printing that, and S of 1 is the same location because two addresses are same, so both will print E. This is another function. Here you can see that there are two functions, main function, and in this function we have declared an array of 4, and these are the values stored in that array, and this is the call of that function array, and we are passing this array ary. I already told you that name of the array can be treated as the pointer variable, so we are passing this this array, and here we are printing this the first location of that array, array of 0. But before that we are calling this function, so we are, when control comes to this function, this call, it will go here, and it will take the value of that address. Okay, so this address will be stored in P. Okay, so the address of this arrow is now stored in P. Now the value of I is equal to 10, which may be a variable, and P equal to ampersand I. So that ampersand I will store address of I into P, and we are printing P of 0. So what should be the output here? So this is an array, 1, 2, 3, 4, this is an array, and ary is the array which we have declared. It means this can be treated as a pointer variable, and this pointer variable is pointing to this array. Okay, and P is another variable, another pointer variable which we have declared here, or array we have declared here. This is also pointing to the same location. Okay, because we have copied these two values. Okay, so P is pointing to the same array. Now the value of I is equal to 10, and now by this statement, by this particular statement, what is happening? We have stored the address of I. Whatever address of I you have, that is stored in P. Okay, now if you print the P of 0, what will be the output? So here you can see that the output is 10 and 1. You have this value, the base location of the array in P. But after execution of this statement, what happens? After execution of this statement, you have removed this address and stored address of I here. Okay, so if you write P of 0, I already told you that P of 0 is equivalent to star P. Okay, P of 0 is equivalent to star P. Okay, so it is printing the address, printing the value which is pointed by the variable contained by P, pointed by P. Okay, so it will print 10, and after printing this, control will come back to it, and array of 0, array is still pointing to, array pointer variable is still pointing to the array. Okay, so it is still printing this, still pointing this, so it is 1. So it will print 1 here. This is another program. This is an array. Just think about this program, what it is doing. Star P is equal to array plus 3, and here we are printing P minus 2. So what do you think? There will be a compiler error. Can you write minus here as an index?
No.
What is happening? Array would be a pointer variable, and you are adding 3 into it. Yes. So what is happening here? This is an array, and this pointer variable is pointing to the first location of array. And what is happening when you add 3 into ary? 3 into ary. You cannot write ary equal to ary plus 3 because you cannot change that. But you can add a constant value into ary and store in any other variable. Left value cannot be ary because that statement would be changing the value of ary, which is not allowed. Okay, so here you are doing ary plus 3. So ary plus 3 will be this value, this location. Okay, so because ary is this, so ary plus 3 will be this location. Okay, and this location, the address of this location is stored in P. This is what you are doing by this statement. Okay, so this statement is storing the address of the last location of array into P. Okay, now if you write P minus 2, so minus 2 means what? You come back, minus 1 is this, minus 2 is this. So actually this is pointing to this location. P of minus 2 is pointing to this location. Then the output will be 2. Okay, consider this program. What we are doing, K++, this is the main function where we have stored this string into the array. And here we are calling this function. So when we are calling this function, control will come to the F, and it will take the address, base address of this array into K. Okay, now we are doing K++, K of 2 equal to M. Let us see how this is progressing. Okay, so what is happening here? This is the array, H-E-L-L-O. This has been stored here by this statement. Okay, and K is also having the same address because we are sending S in the function as an argument, and this argument will be copied here in this pointer variable. So S and K both are pointing to this array right now. Now come to the next point, next statement. K++ is doing what? K++ is just adding in the pointer variable. Okay, so K++ is this. So you are doing this, changing this pointer variable, the address in pointer variable. Now K of 2 is equal to M. So the current location of K is this. K is currently pointing to this. Now K of 2 means you increase this by 2. Okay, so it means currently after execution of this statement, K would be pointing to this particular location, second L. Okay, like this. Okay, so K of 2 equal to M will change the value of this cell and it will replace L by M. Okay, now come to the next. Here what is happening? Printf star K. So what is star K is printing? Currently the value K is pointing to this. Currently K is pointing to this location. Okay, and we want to, by writing star K, we are printing the content of this location. Okay, so this is printing E. By this statement, we are printing E. Now come to the next location. This is what? Star plus plus K. Listen carefully what this statement is doing. Star plus plus K, what it is doing? It is first incrementing in K. Okay, first incrementing in K means the K will now point to the next location like this. Okay, K is pointing to this location. And by placing star, we are printing the content of this location. So it will print L. Okay, now can you tell me what this statement will print? Okay, this statement do what? This will first find the content at location K. Okay, so K is currently pointing to this location and the content of this location is what? L. Okay, and by writing plus plus in that content, what we are doing? We are incrementing. Yes,
it will print M.
Very good, it will print M. Okay, so it will print M because you will get the next ASCII value, and that is the content, the equivalent character will be printed out, and that equivalent character is M after L. Okay, so this is what how it will happen. So E, L and M will be the output. This is the last program, function pointer. Okay, so this is an example of function pointer. You can also have a pointer to a function. Okay, so this is an example here. What you have, you are having a function. This is a function. Okay, add int a, int b. This is a simple function to add two number. There is no problem. But in main function, you are not calling this function by name. You are not writing here add 5, 6. You are not writing like this. But you want to call it by the pointer of this function. Okay. So how will you get pointer to this function? You will declare like this. Okay. Int in this bracket, you will have star fn underscore ptr. This will be the pointer variable which will point to the function, and here you will write the argument type. Okay, so these are the two argument prototyping, int and int. Okay, now fn underscore ptr add. Okay, so here this is how you are assigning the function's address or pointing the address to fn ptr. Okay, so this is the statement by which you are making this function pointer pointing to this function. Now this statement is this is how you can call this function from using pointer fnptr 2, 3, and here you are writing the return type, and this will print you the output, give you the output. Output is 5. Okay.